A plane landing mishap at New York's LaGuardia Airport left 10 people hurt last night, and a New Hampshire woman witnessed the whole thing. The front landing gear of the Southwest Airways flight collapsed right after the plane touched down on the runway, as you can see in this video. A New Hampshire woman was sitting on another plane on that tarmac when this all unfolded. Ray Brewer joins us live in the studio to tell us more about her account of this. Good morning, Ray.
Good morning, Sean. Robin Rowe says she was kind of stunned when she looked out her plane's window, but she says from what she could see, the pilot did a great job, and fortunately, no one was seriously injured.
I was sitting on the tarmac waiting to take off to head to Manchester and looked out the right-hand side of the plane when the Southwest 737 came in for a landing.
This is what Robin Rowe saw as she looked out her window 5:40 Monday evening at LaGuardia Airport. Southwest Flight 345 had taken off from Knoxville, Tennessee, and according to the airline, had 150 people on board. Passengers aboard the flight said they had been delayed taking off in Tennessee, that there had been an announcement about a problem with the tire.
The minute it touched down, the nose gear broke off. You saw quite a few sparks, and then the tire of the nose gear went sailing down the runway past our plane and kind of veered off to the right, and then the plane skidded to a stop.
The passengers had to exit the plane by emergency chutes while firefighters sprayed the front of the aircraft with foam. Rose says on board her plane, there was a sense of disbelief.
Because we all kind of looked around at each other like, did that just happen?
10 passengers were treated at the scene. 6 of those eventually taken to the hospital with what was described as minor injuries. The airline says that the flight crew was also taken to the hospital to be checked out.
The crash landing shut down LaGuardia for more than an hour, although one runway was back open by 7 o'clock. Officials hope to have the airport completely open later this morning. As for the cause, both the FAA and FTSB are investigating. Reporting live in the studio, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.